Good evening, my brothers and sisters in Christ. Welcome to this prayer at the close of the day. It is Wednesday, the 31st day of August, year of our Lord, 2022. We do pray this finds you well this evening. Another beautiful summer day, late summer day. Hopefully you got outside to enjoy some of it. It'll be a very pleasant evening as well. Another good night for gazing at the beauty of the heavens. It's a very dark moon for the next few days, so that won't interfere. So if you can get away from the lights, just it's remarkable that these are the nights I do miss living where I lived. There's a lot of things I miss about Michigan, but it was very rural. We're fairly far north too, relatively speaking, and you could see the galaxy and the dust lanes in the galaxy. That's a remarkable thing. If you go up to the mountains, you can see that as well. I've been blessed to be up in the mountains at night a number of times, and just when you have less atmosphere and when it's dark, it's a little frightening, but the heavens are so beautiful and the sky is so filled with stars. You can easily see the galaxy, and again the dust lanes of the galaxy, which was a remarkable thing to see with your naked eye, I'm just looking up at the sky. And it becomes very difficult to find the constellations, and I'm very familiar with the constellations in the northern hemisphere. Put me in the southern hemisphere, I have no idea. But in the northern hemisphere, I've been looking at my whole life, and I've been studying them, most of my life. And there's so many stars, they're very difficult to spot right away. But they're so bright, that's why they're labeled as constellations. So anyway, go outside and enjoy listen to this verse, and then go outside and enjoy the beautiful summer evening. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord Almighty grant us a quiet night and peace at the last. Amen. It is good to give thanks to the Lord, to sing praise to your name, O Most High, to herald your love in the morning, your truth at the close of the day. And we're going to turn again to the 70th Psalm, and we're going to, it is an inscribed psalm, and we learn that it is to the choir master of David for the memorial offering. And we those inscriptions don't find their way into the hymnal, but the hymnal is pointed for me to make it easier to sing, so I will sing a few. It's a very short psalm, only five verses, and I'll sing that and the Gloria Patri. Make haste, O God, to deliver me. O Lord, make haste to help me. Let them be put to shame and confusion who seek my life. Let them be turned back and brought to dishonor who desire my hurt. Let them turn back because of their shame, who say, aha, aha. May all who seek you rejoice and be glad in you. May those who love your salvation say evermore, God is great. But I am poor and needy. Hasten to me, O God. You are my helper and my deliverer, O Lord, do not delay. Glory be to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now and will be forever. Amen. And again, that is the 70th Psalm, and it is inscribed to the choir master of David for the memorial offering. And a memorial offering was burnt offering, and the aroma of that burnt offering was presented in the temple, in the tabernacle, and it was to remind God, like God was, when we do that, it's for our benefit. It's not like God's going to forget. But it's an interesting thing. That is an interesting theme in the Psalms, this idea of crying out to God and saying, remember your promises. And we can do that. God, of course, allows us to do that. He writes it down for us, in this case, through David, these things. And it's a very comforting thing when we're in this psalm. Is one of those psalms that was written, we don't know the circumstances, but it was written when David was feeling very low, very spiritually lost, perhaps. Obviously it is a a somber psalm, and it's, again, a memorial. Lord, how long? Lord, remember your promises. Remember your steadfast love. And the psalms are full of language like that. And we cry out to God, say, you know, remember, you've promised. You promised. We say that to each other all the time, but we're allowed to say that to God. God, you promised. You promised. That He points us often back to the same word, and we are remembered. We are reminded and called to our remembrance how God has fulfilled His promises. And of course, for us, it's right here in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ. That's where our death was destroyed. That's where our sin was put to death. And in our baptism, we're joined to everything that happened there. So beautiful psalm. Now, you may recognize, I didn't sing it the way we normally sing it in church. Make haste, O God, to deliver me. Make haste to help me, O Lord. That is the beginning of Matins and Vespers, singing of that psalm, that versicle. So a versicle is a portion of a larger reading in Scripture, a small verse, a versicle. So this versicle, Psalm 70, stanza 1, reminds us, okay, deliver us, O God. And think about that. We've gathered in church. In that case, in the case of Matins and Vespers, we've gathered for prayer as one of the ancient prayers. It was a time. It would be a great thing to do. Maybe I'll start it again. I do it in the evenings. But God's people came together at sunup usually for Matins and then went to the divine service, had the Lord's Supper, and then in the evening again gathered for Vespers. So this is prayer at the close of the day, but it's like that. The Matins, though, it is actually a beautiful liturgy. Well, we're going to have to figure out how to do that a little more frequently, because we don't do it on Sunday, but we're going to figure that out, because I know a lot of people who grew up going to Lutheran schools and stuff that love that, and it's a beautiful liturgy. But think about it. When we're immersed in those prayer hours, the first thing we say is, make haste to deliver me. And there we are, usually gathered in church, the place where God says, here is where, you know, you receive you receive Christ who delivered you. And we receive Him through His word. Again, with the font's right there. We're reminded that we're joined to Him in our baptism. We see the altar. We recall the Lord's Supper. So let them be put to shame and confusion who seek my life. In Christ, death has been put to shame and confusion. It's ultimately going to be destroyed, but its power of us has already been taken away. Death for us is merely sleep. Rest in peace. You know, death for us is that rest, and we'll await the resurrection. We know we will rise from the dead because Christ rose from the dead. Let them be turned back and brought to dishonor who desire my hurt. It's always a nice prayer. The people who seek to destroy our faith, Satan, let them be turned to dishonor. Let them turn back because of their shame who say, aha, aha, that's a cry. You know, that's a mocking cry. Aha, aha. May all who seek you, now not in the sense of you know, people are stumbling around looking for God, but David is writing about us, that we come to that place where God promises to be. We call that church, where the word is read, where we're, again, baptisms are performed, where we celebrate the Lord's Supper, where we're reminded of everything God has done for us. So we're seeking that forgiveness. We're seeking again to be reminded of that God is indeed faithful to His promises. So let all who seek you, when we come into that place, Matins, Vespers, the divine service, may all who seek you and be glad in you, may all who seek you rejoice and be glad in you. And it is hard, even on days when, you know, the gospel, when the texts are heavy, we are still, even during Holy Week, as we face Good Friday, those are still days of joy. They're restrained on some of those days when the readings are heavy. But we know, you know, one, when the readings are heavy and maybe are kind of, I always think of it as sort of, you know, giving us the 1-2 punch, which we need upside down. They open our eyes to our condition and they force us to repent and then to look to our Lord Jesus Christ. And then we still leave the church, yes, thinking about our sin and everything, but joy, filled with joy because of the forgiveness that in the midst of our great sin, joy that we have been forgiven in Christ our Lord. May those who love your salvation say evermore, God is great. And when we look to the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, evermore we say, God is great. God is great. We shout our alleluias. I am poor and needy. hasten to me, O God. And when we come into his presence, when we seek that forgiveness, when we seek to remind him of his promises, and then he says, yes, here again is Jesus Christ. Here again is the forgiveness that I told you I would give to you. We remember how poor and needy we are. That's the right posture that we assume when we come into his presence. Not, oh, look how good I was this week, so now do something for me. It's, what can I possibly ask for? So we say those words, the words of beggars, Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Beautiful, the Kyrie. And you are, and then the last half of the last verse of the psalm, so another versicle. You are my help and my deliverer. O Lord, do not delay. And think about it. We say that when we're in his presence, receiving the great gift again of the forgiveness that is ours in Jesus Christ, receiving Jesus Christ, and then leaving that place knowing that we are completely and totally forgiven and heirs of everlasting life. And all this for the sake of Jesus Christ, our Lord. You are my help and my deliverer, God alone. O Lord, do not delay. Beautiful, short psalm. Let's now confess our faith using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father, almighty maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Lord, now you let your servant go in peace. Your word has been fulfilled. My own eyes have seen the salvation which you have prepared in the sight of every people, a light to reveal you to the nations and the glory of your people Israel. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Lord God, Heavenly Father, we pray that you bless the homes of your people, and that marriage and family and husbands and wives and parents and children would be held in honor among your people, and that we would live together according to your ordered harmony, according to what you have revealed in your word, and rejoice in these gifts, and that we may defend these gifts in our community. As always, we pray for parents who must raise their children alone, and that most difficult of tasks, we ask you to keep them from falling into loneliness and despair. Strengthen them that they may apply that vocation effectively as your instrument in these children's lives, and be with us, their neighbors, that we may help as we are able to provide for their needs. May we be a blessing to our communities and our neighborhoods as your people, and may we shine forth with the light of Christ that they may see the gift of faith in you. Heavenly Father, as always, we pray for those who are crying out to you. We ask you this night to be with our brothers and sisters in Christ, Dennis, Donna, Dave, Dawn, Sandy, Mary, for my brothers in office, Mike, Nicholas, Dale, for dear friends of the congregation, Grant, who we have received news today that he's doing better and has returned home, for Heather, for Dave and Anita, for Jason, Katie, for Marge, for Rory, Joan, Bert, Billy, Joe, Dee, Dylan, and Josiah. Heavenly Father, place your healing hand upon them, keeping them ever mindful of your love. Bless their families as they care for them, that they may not despair of your love, and that they may be strengthened. And we ask you to be with the nurses and doctors and all the caregivers, that they might be your instruments for effective healing. In all things, in all situations and circumstances of life, keep us, your children, mindful of your victory even over death itself, and all this through Christ our Lord. For it is in the name of Christ our Lord, the one who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. through whom and in whom we pray. Amen. Visit our dwellings, O Lord, and in your great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. For the love of your only Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. I thank you, my Heavenly Father, through Jesus Christ, your dear Son, that you have graciously kept me this day. And I pray that you would forgive me all my sins where I have done wrong and graciously keep me this night. With your hands, I commend myself, my body, soul, and all things. Let your holy angel be with me, that the evil foe may have no power over me. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. I'm going to sing a beautiful Melanchthon hymn, one of my favorites. I sing it frequently. Lord Jesus Christ, with us abide. Lord Jesus Christ, with us abide, for round us falls the eventide. Oh, let your word, that saving light, shine forth undimmed into the night. In these last days of great distress, grant us, dear Lord, true steadfastness, that we keep pure till life is spent, your holy word and sacrament. To hope grown dim, to hearts turn cold, speak tongues of fire and make us bold. To shine your word of saving grace into each dark and loveless place. May glorious truths that we have heard, the bright sword of your mighty word, spurn Satan, that your church be strong, bold, unified in act and song. Restrain, O Lord, the human pride that seeks to thrust your truth aside, or with some man-made thoughts or things would dim the words your Spirit sings. Stay with us, Lord, and keep us true. Preserve our faith a whole life through. Your word alone, our heart's defense, the church's glorious confidence. And that's hymn 585, Lord Jesus Christ, with us abide. With that, my brothers and sisters, I bid you a blessed evening. And by God's grace, we'll see you tomorrow night. Good night.